इंटरनेट, फाइन. सो वी हैव टू डिस्कस अबाउट दिस इंटरनेट, देन वी विल लर्न द एप्लीकेशन एंड देन सम अदर टर्म्स. सो नाउ लेट्स बिगिन. वेल, इंटरनेट इज अ वाइडली स्प्रेड नेटवर्क. इट्स अ वर्ल्ड वाइड नेटवर्क ऑफ कंप्यूटर्स एंड इट इज ऑफन टर्म्ड एज नेटवर्क ऑफ नेटवर्क्स, फाइन. सो इट्स अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ मल्टीपल नेटवर्क्स अराउंड द वर्ल्ड. थ्रू इंटरनेट कंप्यूटर्स बिकम एबल टू एक्सचेंज इन्फॉर्मेशन विद ईच अदर, फाइन. In easy words, we can say that by using this internet, computers can very easily share information with each other. Fine. It is also termed as interconnection of computer networks. Fine. We can also term this internet as interconnection of computer networks. It means in this, multiple computer networks are connected with each other. Now, every computer in internet has a unique address or has a unique IP address. Fine. Our IP address is a number. Something like this, fine. And this unique IP address is used to identify a device or it is a location of a computer in the network, fine. So this internet is a connection of multiple networks around the world, and we can say that it's a global system of networking. Now it has some applications that we have to discuss one by one. The first application of internet is electronic messaging. Fine. Well, by the use of internet, we can send or receive messages. These messages can be emails, SMS, or our chatting process that we do by using social networking apps. Fine. So it means in this internet, we can send or receive messages, and that's a very instant process. Fine. The next application of the internet is termed as electronic data interchange. This electronic data interchange is the method of sharing data by using the internet or data over the internet, fine. In this data, we can use multiple file formats. It means if in case I'm sharing a PDF with you, or if I'm sharing a video with you, if I'm sharing an audio clip with you, so that will be the part of this EDI or this electronic data interchange, fine. The next is teleconferencing. Now this teleconferencing means performing the process of conferencing, fine. Conferencing means to communicate, fine. So it's a method of communication between two or more individuals, fine. There are two types of conferencing. The first is termed as video conferencing and the second one is termed as audio conferencing. In a video conferencing, we can make video calls where we can see each other and we can also talk to each other, whereas in the audio conferencing, we can only listen the voice, we cannot display a picture, fine. Or in this video conferencing, both audio and video are available, whereas in the audio conferencing, only the audio is available. Then the next is EFT, that is electronic fund transfer. This electronic fund transfer is a method of transferring money without going to the bank. Fine. Here we have multiple applications, like we have net banking, we have ATMs, we have some banking apps, and by using all these things, we can transfer our money from one account to another without going to the bank. Fine. Now there are some important terms which are related to internet. We have to discuss all these terms in detail. So we are starting with our first term. Now our first term is URL. Fine. This URL stands for Uniform Resource Locator. As the name suggests, it is a locator. It means it will help us to locate something. Now what is that something? We have to discuss about that. A URL is a unique identifier. What is it? It's a unique identifier. It means it's every time different for every new website or address used to locate a resource on the internet. Now let's discuss this term first. This URL is a name or it's an address that is given to a particular website, and this name or this address is unique for every website. Like in this whole world, we can only have one amazon.com, fine. A person cannot use this name amazon.com for his or her own need, fine. We can only have one name with one website, and that is the feature of this URL, fine, because that name is the address of that particular website, fine. This URL is often termed as web address. It is also termed as web address. Now generally a structure of a URL is something like this. It has a protocol, then a server, then a path, fine. Now we have example also, as you can see over here. We have this very simple example here. We have our school's website. It has a protocol called HTTP. Then we have this server address or the website name, and then at last we have the path or the file that we have to open. Fine. Generally in our URL we have three parts. These three parts are the protocol, then the server address, and then the path. In the protocol, most probably we have to use the HTTP. Fine. Now HTTP stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol. It will define the type of protocol that is to be used with this particular website. Fine. Now because we are using a website, we are sharing a website, so we will use HTTP. If in case you were sharing some other resources, then this protocol will be different for that. Well, after that we have this www.vaccnblock.com. This whole is termed as our server address. It is the address of our web server where our website is stored. Fine. This is it consists of two things, that is domain name and domain extension. This name which is written over here, that is vaccnblock, it is termed as our domain name, and this .com is the extension. Fine. So it means this vaccnblock is the domain name and this .com is the extension. And after this slash we have this term home. This home is the location of the resource or the page that we have to open. Fine. Now suppose in this vaccnblock you have to open the home page. So you will write vaccnblock.com/home. So after that slash you are writing home. So home means a directory or a file that you want to access. Then next most important term in the internet is termed as ISP. This ISP is the company or it is the organization which provides us the connectivity to use the internet. Fine. Now let's suppose one thing. In our phones or in our computers we have an internet connection. Fine. Most probably we use some SIM cards in our mobile phones. Fine. We all have a Jio SIM with us. Fine. So that Jio SIM which is providing us an internet connection, it's a type of ISP. Fine. So we have multiple ISPs around us like Airtel, Jio, BSNL, MTNL, DEN, etc. Fine. So all the companies which are providing you an internet connection, these companies are termed as the ISP. It means all these companies like Jio, BSNL, Vodafone, Airtel, fine, all these companies are the ISPs which are providing us the internet service. Fine. Now the next term is, now the next most important thing is that the charges that we pay to this ISP, it depends on the connection speed. Fine. All these companies generally take some money from us, and that money depends on the data connectivity that we are getting. Fine. If you are getting high speed, then the cost will be high, but if in case you are getting a low speed, then the cost will be low. Fine. And generally this speed of data connectivity is measured in Mbps or Kbps, where Mbps stands for megabits per second. Fine. Keep this term in your mind. It is megabits per second, not megabytes per second. Mbps stands for megabits per second, and this Kbps stands for kilobits per second. Fine. If this b is in small case, if this b is in small case, then it stands for bits, whereas if this b was in capital case, then it will stand for bytes. Fine. So agar ye hum logo ka likha hua hai small mein kbps, then it will be kilobits per second, but if it was kb with capital b, then it will be the bytes per seconds. Fine. So generally our speed is in bits per second. Now the next most important term in the net is ip address. Well, as we all have a home address, we have a block number, we have our mobile number. Similarly, every computer on internet has a unique address, and that address is termed as the IP address. Fine. This IP address is also in American form. Fine. So in this IP address, this IP address is also termed as an identification number of a network device, which allows it to communicate with each other. It means on internet, every computer, every website, every resource will have this particular unique number. Fine. So whenever we use a computer for networking purpose, we are using our IP. If you are accessing any website, it means you are accessing that IP address. You are not actually accessing that website, but what you are doing, you are just simply asking for that particular IP address from the web server. Fine. This IP address is a combination of four sets. Fine. There's an example given over here. You can see that in this example, we have four sets. The first one, it is the second one, then it's our third set, and then it's our four sets. Fine. Now each set is a combination of three digit number, but for that number we have a range. That three digit number can lie in between 0 to 255. Fine. So you can pick any number in between 0 to 255 over here, and then it will help you to create a IP address. Fine. All these four parts are separated by the dots. Next is domain name system. Well, every website on internet has a unique name. For example, our school has a name, that is vaccnblock.com. Fine. Similarly, Google has a unique name, that is google.com. Then some other organizations have their own websites. Fine. So every website on internet has a unique name. They have a unique extension also. Likewise, our school website is vaccnblog.com. Fine. Then there's a website called vacc.in. Then we have some other websites in which we have this .co.in. Fine. So at the end of every website name, we have an extension. And then we have some unique names. Fine. So we have to discuss about this naming system now. Now, it is a system used for identifying the location of various web resources like web pages or websites on the web servers. Fine. Now, on our web servers or in the internet, we have so many websites available there. So every website has a unique name or a unique location. Okay. So this domain naming system is a method for naming these websites on the web. Okay. Now, in every website name, we have two parts of domain name and our domain extension. For example, over here that you can see, we have vaccnblog.com. So this vaccnblog is the domain name, whereas this .com is the domain extension. Okay. Now we have various type of extensions. As you can see over here, we have .com, we have .org, .net, .gov, .mil, .in, .edu. Fine. Every extension has a unique meaning. Like for .com stands for commercial website. Fine. It means website of any company. Then .org stands for non-profit organization. Then .net stands for network resource or something which is related to IT. Then .gov stands for government websites. .mil stands for military websites. And .in stands for Indian website. If in case you have a .uk, .us, .au, fine. So these are the websites of UK is for United Kingdom, that is Great Britain. Then US is for United States of America. Then we have AU for Australia, fine. But if we have the extension as .edu or .ac, so EDU or AC stands for educational or academic website, fine. So in every website name, we have an extension part and then we have a domain name, okay. Then next we have web page, website and web portal. Well, these three are most common and mostly related terms, so that's why I have written them in a single sheet. So we have to discuss about all of these one by one. So first we will discuss about this web page. Generally on internet, whenever we open any website, the page that we are able to see, that page is termed as our web page. Fine. So we can say that an individual document on the web server which contains the related information in the form of text, image, audio or video is termed as web page. Fine. In easy words, we can say that any individual document on internet which contains information like text, image, audio or video is termed as web page. And for creating these web pages, we have to use a language that is termed as HTML. Fine. And I hope that you all have learned this HTML in the class 6 or in class 7. Okay. Now, this HTML is used for creating web pages. Okay. So it means with the help of this HTML, we can create web pages. Now, the next is websites. Now, the combination of these several web pages, the combination of all these web pages creates a website. Okay. So the website is a collection of related web pages stored in a web server. And these pages are linked to each other through hyperlinks. Okay. So it means all the web pages when are interlinked, then it creates a website. Now, next important term we have as web portal. Ab ek important cheez hai beta yahan par. Generally, we have an important question, that is what is the difference between a website and a web portal. So, usko bilkul dhyan se samajhiyega, because this question can be asked in the exams also. Okay. So, now a web portal is a special type of website which provides wide range of services like email, gaming, search engine, shopping and some other services. Fine. So, it means we have a website where we can get multiple services. Fine. Suppose a website is giving you a service of posting your blogs, chatting with others, searching something, playing online games, then that will be a web portal. For example, if we talk about Google, so Google has a mailing service, fine, it has a chatting service also, it has Google Duo for making calls, it has Google Photos for storing photos, it has so many applications which are the part of this Google only. Fine, so we can say that this Google is a web portal. Similarly, we have Rediff and Yahoo. So all these applications are the web portals. Whereas if we talk about a website, let's say Amazon, So Amazon has a specific task. In Amazon, we can only perform shopping. So Amazon is a type of website. Fine. Then next we have bandwidth. Now this bandwidth is a very important term. Okay. So you must have to write all these terms in the notebook. All these terms are available in that PDF sheet. Fine. This bandwidth is referred to the amount of data that can be transmitted. It should be transmitted. Fine. That can be transmitted in a fixed period of time. Fine. So the amount of data that a PC can transmit or that a network can transmit in a fixed time is termed as the bandwidth. And generally this bandwidth is measured in BPS, KBPS or MBPS. Fine. This BPS stands for bits per second. BPS stands for bits per second. KBPS stands for kilobits per second. And MBPS stands for megabits per second. Then next we have hyperlinks. A hyperlink is an HTML object which is used to connect web pages. I think we have learned this part earlier. In last year's syllabus, we have discussed this term already. Fine. So an hyperlink is an HTML object which is generally used to create the links. Then next we have hypertext. So the text which has linking capability is termed as hypertext. And when we click on this text, it will redirect you to some other page. Now we have to discuss about some networking devices. Our first networking device is modem. This modem stands for modulator and demodulator. Fine. Modem stands for modulator and demodulator. This modem generally converts the digital signal into the analog form. Fine. There are two types of modems, internal modem and external modem. Fine. Now this internal modem is something like this. And the external modem appears something like this. Fine. So these are the networking devices which will help you to be in a network. Then next we have hub and switch. This hub and switch are two most important devices in a computer network. Well, suppose we have to connect two or more computers in a network. Now for connecting two or more computers, we need a central device. So this hub is that particular central device which will manage the traffic of the computers. Okay. So this hub is a central device that manages the flow of data across the network. A hub divides the bandwidth or communication speed equally. Fine, the best important thing is that this hub divides the speed equally between multiple computers. Fine. Then next we have switch. Switch, we can say that it's a bigger version of hub. In the switch, we can connect more computers and it is more dedicated in compared to the hub. Switch is also a central device, but it provides signals only to the desired devices. Fine. So it means it will only communicate with those nodes which are giving a request signal. Fine. So that's why it is more dedicated in compared to the hub. Then next we have router and gateway. Router is a network device which is used to route the data across the different parts of a network. Fine. It is generally used for creating wireless networks. As you can see, we have some wireless antennas over here. So it is generally used to create the wireless networking. So that's why it is used in WAN. Next we have gateway. As the name suggests, it is a connection point of multiple networks. Fine. So gateway is a piece of networking hardware which is used in telecommunication. Fine. So it helps us to connect multiple networks or multiple small networking components to create a telecommunication network.